today we're going to be thinking about the water cycle. Now we asked you to do a little bit of research about this at the start of the week, so hopefully you will have done that, and this will be an activity which supports the research and learning you've already done. Now we were actually supposed to be looking at the water cycle this half term, of course we're not able to, but I just wanted you to experience a little bit of what we would have been learning about. Okay, we're going to be thinking about the different processes that happen in the water cycle. I'm going to be explaining these a little bit to you, but of course you should have already done some research about it. And then we're going to have an activity at the end that you can have a go at home. Okay, so we've got some facts here. You might want to pause the video and just have a little read of them, but some of them include the fact that more than 3/4 of the Earth's surface is actually water, which is quite an interesting little fact. So this is the water cycle, the whole thing. This is what we're going to be looking at today, and I'm going to run us through some of the processes really quickly as we do this video. Okay, so the first process is evaporation, which is when the sun heats up water. This can be from lakes, the sea, anywhere really, and it goes up into the sky because it is evaporating and turning into water vapor. Now, condensation is when this water vapor collects in the form of clouds, and because of the wind, those clouds are able to move to different locations, which is why you get rain in different areas. So precipitation is when this water vapor eventually becomes rain, and it comes back down to the earth. We all know a lot about rain. We've all been stuck in it. It's a bit horrible, it's very wet. And that is water that's moved from many different locations and formed together. And now it is coming back down in the form of a liquid. Okay, this water then collects in the rivers and streams, but some of it also goes underground into underground water storage. And this can go into the soil. Water generally eventually runs back to the sea, or it might collect again in the ponds or the lakes or things like that. Okay, so your task for today is to create your own water cycle. Now I know you're thinking, well, how is that going to work? But it's very, very simple. All you are going to need is a sandwich bag, a marker, some water, and blue dye if you are able to get it. So we can have a little look at these pictures here. Now what they've done is they have drawn the lake, the ocean, the puddle at the bottom, which is where our water is beginning. Then we've got the evaporation process going up, where it has been heated up and turned into a more gassy water vapor. And then you've got the clouds and the condensation, where of course it collects as clumps, and then the precipitation comes down here. Now you can see these water droplets. This is actually from where the water has evaporated, and then it's forming the water again and preparing to come back down into our lake, ocean, puddle, whatever you want to call it. Now what you're going to do, it might be easier if you actually have a Ziploc bag, but it doesn't particularly matter. We did it with these last year, I believe. So you're going to get your bag, and I've got my marker, and I'm going to do a very, very quick drawing. You can make it much more fancy if you want to, but I'm going to draw my lake at the bottom, and then up the side, like we had before, I'm going to draw the evaporation process. Just like that. And then up here, of course, I'm going to have my clouds. What a wonderful cloud that is, which is condensation. And then down the side over here, you have guessed it, is going to be our rain and precipitation. Okay, and then all you have to do, I'm going to do it with some normal water today, but you can add blue dye to your water if you want. You have to open the bag up, get some water, and you're going to pour some water into the bag. Make sure to check that there isn't any holes in your bag before you start. So as you can see, I've got water in my bag down at the lake section. I'm going to close my bag very carefully so the water isn't able to fall out. And then what you're going to do, I haven't got any with me, but you're going to get some sticky tape and find a lovely window where all the sun is coming in, and you're going to stick it up there just like that. So your sticky tape would go along here. And then as the week goes on, you will be able to watch the process of the water evaporating, collecting up here, and then coming back down in the form of droplets. And you can actually already see some droplets forming where the water cycle process has started. Okay.